Quezon City is one of the hotly contested areas in this year's elections. Zian Ambrosio now joins us with an update. Zian, over to you.
Carmina, 400 voters are now here at the Christ the King Seminary polling precinct. Incumbent Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte just voted with her husband Raymond Alimorong here at the Christ the King Seminary polling precinct. With them was the father of Mayor Joy, former House Speaker Sonny Belmonte. Former House Speaker Sonny Belmonte was able to finish early as he queued at the senior citizen lane. According to Jason Hernandez, DepEd Supervising Officer of Barangay Kristong Hari polling precinct, the reason for the long lines was because of the influx of voters who preferred to vote early. Comelec was the one who also assigned the cluster of the 15 precincts here in Barangay Kristong Hari. There are four precincts per cluster. There are 600 voters per clustered precinct. Ferdinand Fernandez explained that it is difficult to have one machine per precinct and there is not enough deployment of teachers. Here in Quezon City politics, the most known contender of Belmonte is Congressman Mike Defensor of the Anakalusugan Party list, who has already voted this morning at the La Vista Subdivision polling precinct. Belmonte is running for her second term in office with incumbent Vice Mayor Gian Soto. Aside from Belmonte and Defensor, there are more candidates, including Rick Bello of PDSP, Jose Ingles of WPP, and five more independent candidates. And that's the latest here in Quezon City. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Zian Ambrosio there, joining us live from Quezon City. Most presidential and vice presidential bets have cast their ballots in what is considered to be one of the most pivotal elections in Philippine history. Among the early birds, presidential candidate Panfilo Lacson. The senator voted at the Bayan Luma Elementary School in Cavite. He was among the first in line at the precinct. Also early at the voting precinct this morning, survey frontrunner Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. He was at the Mariano Marcos Memorial Elementary School in Ilocos Norte around 7 this morning. Labor leader Lodi de Guzman, meanwhile, voted past 8 this morning. He cast his ballot at the Cainta Elementary School. Vice President Leni Robredo was able to cast her vote after waiting in line for almost 2 hours at the Carangcang Elementary School in Magarao, Camarines Sur. Meanwhile, Mayor Francisco Esco Moreno Dumagoso cast his vote in his bailiwick, Manila. And Senator Manny Pacquiao also done voting at the Kiamba Central Elementary School in Sarangani Province. On to the vice presidential candidates, Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio cast her ballot at the Daniel R. Aguinaldo National High School in Davao City at past 9 this morning. Senator Francis Kiko Pangilinan is waiting in line at the Inchican Elementary School in Silang, Cavite. He is with his wife, actress Sharon Cuneta. And Senator Tito Soto cast his vote in White Plains, Quezon City with his wife, actress Helen Gamboa. Vice presidential candidate Dr. Willie Ong, he's also done voting. He cast his ballot in Makati City. The Election Commission says their technical support center is already working to address vote counting machine breakdowns in parts of the country. Instead of waiting for the VCMs to be fixed, voters were asked to just leave their ballot with the electoral board, who will then feed it into the VCM later in the day. COMELEC acting spokesperson Rex Laudianco assures Filipinos this is among the approved contingency measures of the poll body.
We invite all the voters to witness the batch feeding later on in the day. Of course, since having with them having already cast their vote, they will not be allowed to go inside anymore, inside the precinct anymore, because of the space restrictions as well as to ensure minimum public health standards. But as you could see in all the precincts throughout the country, the windows are all open. They could view the batch feeding as well as the other proceedings of the electoral boards through the window.
Other election mishaps reported were the lack of voting receipts and a corrupted VCM SD card. Voting was also delayed in parts of Cotabato as police personnel took over the city's electoral board members. Acting COMELEC spokesperson Rex Laudianco says some teachers backed out from facilitating the elections due to perceived threats to their safety.
wala naman pong actually na nasaktan doon sa mga electoral boards or na threatened, but they perceived threats to their persons. Kaya po they manifested na po to our officials that they opted not to serve. The Election Service Reform Act specifically allows and provides for PNP personnel to serve as electoral boards kapag ka po merong ganito, matters of security and matters of emergency.
Meanwhile, the COMELEC assured residents of Bukidnon the Energy Department is already working to address the fluctuating power situation in the province.
We have plan B. We have the batteries. Okay? What we have plan C, we also have generators. So everything else fail pagdating sa energy. Same standard contingency measure, tuloy po ang botohan. Hindi po hihinto dahil pwede naman pong bumoto sa pamagitan lamang ng balota. And then iba-batch feed po natin sila under the watch of the watchers and the accredited citizens arm.